From the Small Press Expo at the Marriott Bethesda North Hotel and Conference Center, the 2015 Ignatz Awards, with Mistress of Ceremonies, C. Spike Trotman. The Ignatz Awards are sponsored by Comixology Submit. Comixology Submit, find your audience. And now, here is SPX Executive Director, Warren Bernard.
Thanks, everybody, for coming. This is kind of a special SPX for us. Okay, it wasn't because of my birthday, okay? This is actually SPX's 21st birthday. And so we're now legal to drink, all right? Which I want, of course, everyone to do once we get out of here, all right? But one of the things we did for this 21st birthday is we invited a whole bunch of people who have only worked in the 21st century. We wanted to do for this group of cartoonists, we did last year for the Alt Weekly people, and we did back in 2012 for, you know, Dan Clowes and Chris Ware and the Hernandez brothers for that generation. So I just want to read you the list of people that we have as guests this year, because this is like, I've not seen this many people together, and this is one of those times when you may not see this group of people together. So this is just the 21st century people before I get to the old people, okay? Breck Vandenbroek, Spike. Okay. Gemma Coral. Jennifer Hayden, amazingly enough. Jennifer and I had this very interesting discussion about people who didn't get into comics until they were older. Okay, and so she has only been really doing it since the dawn of the 21st century. Of course, Kate, and by the way, having both Kate and Noelle at the same place at the same time. I don't know about you, I was thrilled to death. Let me see, Lily Carey. Okay, Lily, I remember when she was here selling her mini comics. Okay, which I fortunately still have in my collection. Luke, okay, and having both Luke and Mr. DeForge in the same place at the same time is pretty cool, but I'm biased. Matt, Mr. Boers over here from the NIB. Mr. Van Skyver, wherever he is. Thanks a lot. Yeah, Noah. I said Noel, and then Theo Ellsworth. Theo, if you're out there, Barry, thanks a lot for bringing him. And then, of course, all right, these are the old people, all right. Oh, I'm sorry, also Benda Kaltenborn is also here from the, you know, his stuff in the New Yorker is like pretty amazing. For those people who worked in the previous century, Brendan Graham, my good buddy Durf, okay, Dylan Horrocks. Dylan, are you here? I don't know if you're here or not. He came, and by the way, he came the furthest. He came all the way from New Zealand just to be with us.
37 hours.
Right, yeah, no, I've done that trip. It's a long time to get here, okay? Jessica Abel, Frederick Peters came all the way from Geneva. We're real happy to have had him. Jessica Abel, Juan Cornea came from Spain. Let me see. Then we had Catherine Stewart Immonen, Scott McLeod, Phoebe Glockner, who, by the way, if you haven't seen her, she's got a great movie, Diary of a Teenage Girl. It's out now. That's getting like these rave reviews. So go see the film. Go buy her book and, you know, buy her other stuff. It's amazing stuff. Scott McLeod. I'm sorry, I'm doing this basically in alphabetical order, so I hope I didn't offend anybody, okay? And I'm sorry, Ted, Mr. Rall, you were last on the alphabetical list, okay? So anyway, so that gives you, you know, so we really tried to go ahead and focus on the 21st century people and then had a bunch of old people in there too. Now, you know, we're all volunteers, so when you see the people out there handing out badges or standing in front of the doors, they're no different than myself or anybody else that's working on SPX. But I want to talk about, you know, all of us and, you know, kind of thank a whole bunch of people. So I want to start with Eden here, the goddess of the Ignatz Awards, and notice, now wait a minute. And over here, I just want to look who we have. We have Jen Vaughn. Okay.
Fight!
So Jen's joined us on the executive committee. We are like amazingly happy that she's with us. I just hope she doesn't run away screaming, tearing all of her beautifully colored hair out. Okay.
Once I worked with Gary Groth, I can work with anybody.
Oh, okay. Snap. Okay. All right. So next, the ever dapper, Mr. Thomas, on social media. Okay. And a whole bunch of other stuff. Sam Marks. Sam, okay. The exhibitor hall. Right. There's a reason why he doesn't have any hair. Okay. I want to talk about programming for a second. Bill, you here? All right. I want a really big hand for Bill. I mean, super big hand for Bill. As you know, we put this out when we announced the programming. You know, Bill has been in charge of the programming for 9 long years. Okay, it's an amazing amount of time. He's done an amazing work. He's like set up SPX as one of the premier places in terms of programming. He's still going to be with us. He's still on the executive committee. He's still going to help us out, but he's not going to be doing all the heavy lifting. Okay, because after 9 years, I'd go running and screaming too. All right, even though this is my 5th year, so I have 4 more to go. So anyway, Bill, can't thank you enough for all the stuff that you've done. All right. And so helping out, where's Esther? 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 Oh, well, Esther's not here, so we'll have to clap in absentia for her. Esther's kind of taking the heavy lifting over from Bill for all the programming, so. I want to talk about the groups of volunteers that you see, led by, where's Dan Stafford? There he is. Okay, Dan the man, all right. And he has with him Yitzi, Megan, and Bailey. Where are they? These are the people that are like out there, right? You know, here's Yitzi over here. Okay. Really, really great that, to, you know, Dan, Yitzi, Megan, and Bailey, the four of them basically hold that front foyer together, which is like no mean feat. So I can't thank them enough. Let's see. We have the graphic novel gift program, Goddess, where's Catherine? Okay, there's Catherine over here. I'll talk about that in a second. Let me see. Where's Sarah? Sarah is a master organizer. Okay, so. And then hopefully I didn't forget anybody. Last but not least is, where's Mr. Barrar? Tom, back there, okay. Our AV specialist, make sure the programs go off and stuff like that. And I want to point out two kind of adjunct people in the back is Ulysses Campbell, who's doing all the video. All right. And he's the official videographer. And then we actually have an official photographer. So let's hear it from Meredith Rizzo down here, who does all the great photos. All right, now, did I miss anybody? You know, I don't want to get, you know, get people pissed at me. All right, who cares? All right. All right, great. So I just want to talk about, you know, I always do like a state of SPX type thing. So I always keep this hopefully short. So real quick, for a graphic novel gift program, this is like the 5th year we've done this. We gave, what, about 300 books through the Anne Arundel Public Library, all stuff just from SPX creators. And this makes, with this contribution this year, we've now put 1,700 books by SPX creators into local library systems in the Washington, D.C. area. And I want to say, everything that we do, if you take a look at all the stuff that we do, and as I go through this list of stuff, everything that's in there is not for SPX, it's for the creator community, okay? So as we go through these, keep in mind what it is that we're trying to do, okay? The Library of Congress, we have the SPX collection at the Library of Congress. With the contributions we're getting this year, with all the Ignatz submissions and the women who come from the Library of Congress, the curators, to go ahead and, you know, pick up stuff. We're now like over 4,000 objects in the collection. Mini comics, posters, graphic novels, all of the stuff that is ephemeral is now sitting in the Library of Congress. And if you go there now, there are actually 3 cases in the main lobby of the Jefferson Building that's all about SPX. Okay. So we're And to emphasize this, I forgot who I was talking to, but they were like, they went to the gala, which I'll get into in a second, for the National Book Festival, and they realized that right next to them was a Gutenberg Bible. Our display is not that far away from the Gutenberg Bible. Okay? But think about that for a second, okay? One of our things is to be sure that this art form gets elevated to the point that we are worthy of such institutions. Okay? And we're going to continue this, and I've got more stuff. So anyway, for the National Book Festival, for the last 3 years, we've brought creators in who couldn't have otherwise gotten here to go into the National Book Festival and give talks and sign books. And this year, we brought in Miss Lasco Gross. Is she around, Miss? Are you here? Nope. All right. Well, I'm batting like zero. Diane Newman came, and then Keith Knight. And I'm sure Keith isn't here. He's probably out eating somewhere. Okay. We went ahead and also had an SPX lecture at the Library of Congress. Now, every Friday before SPX, we have someone from the SPX community come and speak at the Library of Congress. And this year, we had Josh, Andrew, and Chris from Locust Moon Books give this amazing talk about their Little Nemo Dream Little Dream book. That the audio is already out there. They'll put the video up in the next 6 weeks. We'll get it out of social media. They did a phenomenal job. And all these curators came, and all these book fans came. And it was really amazing to see them come to the Library of Congress to go ahead and give that talk. All right. I want to go ahead. So I did the graphic novel gift program. Sorry, it's a lot of stuff, so I took notes. Okay. Let me see. As you know, we're big fans of CBLDF, and we actually give a large portion of our surplus. We don't really, nonprofits really don't do profit, and none of us get paid. So whatever money we can do, we give to CBLDF. So we're big fans of them, and, if you see them, they're trying to raise money, by all means, go ahead and do it. I love Charles. I love the work that they're doing, and I hate people who censor. No, really, okay? And I think everybody in the executive committee will say the same thing. We just don't like people who want to censor our comics. Period, end of statement. We just don't like it, and we're supporting those guys. Now, I also want to thank the sponsors for this year. And I want to talk a little bit about sponsorships, because this is something very important going forward. All right? We only have certain ways to raise revenue. Okay? We either go ahead and try to get more sponsorships in, or we have to go ahead and do things like, raise the admission price or raise the price of the tables. So starting this coming fall, we're going to start looking at different ways to bring more sponsorship money into SPX. And I want to be very clear about how we're assessing this. We're not doing any sponsorship that doesn't also benefit either SPX as an organization in some other tangible way besides the cash or the creator community. And I want to give a couple of examples of that. Okay, the first example is where's Chip? Chip's over there, okay? So you have Comixology. They've been supporting the Ignatz Awards, and this is a platform that allows people to make money with their comics. Period, end of statement, okay? And we also get social media benefit from them. So they advertise, they've done a tremendous job advertising the Ignatz Awards on their social media platforms for Comixology Submit and the Amazon website, okay, to get visibility for those people that have been nominated, all right? And then we have the Nickelodeon people. For this year is the first year we've done something like this. And this is an opportunity for someone here to hopefully go ahead and get a revenue stream by being able to go ahead and do animation. And this is not something that's new to the SPX community. We've had a whole bunch of people go out to California from here. You have Lisa Hannawalt, you have Monica Ray, who just came. I think Daryl Io, there's a whole bunch of people. Sam Alden, right, yeah. So all these people are SPXers, and people from the Comedy Network and Nickelodeon have been coming into SPX for years, okay? Coming to get the talent. Well, let's go ahead and help them and try to get some of their money, and I don't mind taking their money. Really don't. And we'll be sure it's low-key. If you notice, it's been very low-key. But also, guess what? To give someone here or someone's here an opportunity to go ahead and have a different revenue stream. This is not in place of or instead of comics. This is something else that they have as a career path, and a lot of people have chosen that. So these are some of the kinds of things that we're going to be looking at going forward. So we're going to be doing more of this. And so, we're going to be coming up for air as, into the 2016 thing. And I want to talk about 2016 for a second because I've got the dates. September 17th and 18th, 2016, right here, same place, and I've already got two guests to announce. Coming back for the first time in a couple of years, and by the way, very glad we've got him, is Jeffrey Brown, who, if you haven't read his Star Wars stuff, okay, absolutely brilliant. So we were real happy, you know, I was able to talk with Jeff, and actually he almost came this year, but he could only come like Saturday for like 4 hours, and we agreed that really wasn't worth anybody's while. And the other person we have coming is Daniel Klaus. He's coming. I also want to say, I just got finished signing contracts out into 2020, and I have some good news for everybody. In the next 5 years, the price of the hotel rooms here will only go up by $5. All right. So, you know, this is an example. We're very conscious of the incomes that people have that either come to be here as an exhibitor or come to be here as an attendee. And as you can tell, we're trying to go ahead and be very conscious of what we can do to go ahead to make your lives economically easier so that you have more money to spend on, like rent and food and, you know, stuff like that.
And comics,
yeah, right. So anyhow, I think I've exceeded my 6 minutes, all right? But thank you very much. I'm going to turn it over to Goddess Eden, and I hope she doesn't kill me for going past my 6 minutes, okay? Thank you. And
so hi, I only have a few things to say. I would like to thank our jury because they have such a huge task. We are now getting about 600 submissions, and all goes to their homes, and they get to read them all. But I think they always do an amazing job putting together the nominees. I really don't envy them. And just also everyone who submitted, and I would also like to thank Jen for helping me put together the ceremony tonight. So you already got a little taste of Spike early on. But in case you don't know who she is, C. Spike Trotman is a self-publishing phenom with the webcomic Templar Arizona under her belt, in addition to many other successful books like Smut Peddler, Poorcraft, The Sleep of Reason, and the brand new TJ and Amal Omnibus. So I'd like to hand it over to Spike.
I like attention. Hi, everybody. I hope you guys are having a great SPX. I know I am. I'm glad everybody could come. I hope you guys go to the prom afterwards so you don't go back to your room and I can go to my room and go to sleep and not hear you guys through the walls. Okay, I'm supposed to just go straight into, like, you know, who's doing all the presentations, but I just want to say, like, straight on, no bullshit, like, the future of comics is in this room, honest to God. This is like the bleeding edge of what's going on right now, like web comics and mini comics and kind of the resurgence, rather, and interest in zines, and more people are reading graphic novels than ever before, and there's more space for graphic novels, not just in like libraries and on people's personal shelves, but also in bookstores. I remember reading somewhere it was like one of two publishing genres that actually grew in the past year or something like that. It was us and like Western romance or something. Which is fine. If you want to fuck a cowboy, that's cool. I've got some weird shit on my Tumblr. I'm not about to judge anybody. But yeah, it's just, I can't wait to do my walk around tomorrow because that's always the most exciting part of the con for me personally. That's when I get to see people who are going to be like super hot shit in like 3 to 5 years, you know, people who are going to move out to California, like Warren said, and next thing you know, in like 6 or 7 years, they're going to have a show on Cartoon Network or whatever, or on, what's it called, Cartoon Hangover or something, and that's really cool and really exciting. And while I think comics kind of has a self-effacing problem. I think we like to talk trash about ourselves. This is, in my entire life, this is the best place comics has been in, ever. I don't know if anyone here realizes it or not, but this is a golden age. It hasn't been this fun and this exciting in a long time. So, round of applause for everyone. Just wanted to do that little group hug there. Okay, so let's get started giving out these awards so we can get this over with, right? Right. Okay, the first award we are giving out is Best Story, or as it says on the slide, Outstanding Story. This does not correlate with what is up there. I should just make shit up. Okay, our presenter is Alexis Zirit. Am I pronouncing that right, Alexis? Cool. Alexis Zirit is an illustrator by day and a Harvey Award-winning comic book artist by night. He's originally from Venezuela, but he now resides in beautiful, sunny Florida. Some of his works include The Package and Space Riders, in addition to t-shirt designs for his own apparel company called Fistful Apparel, and prints for the Super Comic Books Art Collective, Out of Step Arts. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, Alexis Zirit.
Hola. So, Doctors by Dutch Shaw, Me as a Baby for Loose Number 6 by Michael DeForge, Nature Lesson from the Late Child and Other Animals by Marguerite Van Cook and James Romberger, Sex Coven. From Frontier Number 7 by Gillian Tamaki. And Weeping Flower, Grows in Darkness by Chris Mukai. And the winner is Sex Coven from Frontier Number 7.
So Jillian couldn't make it, so I'm accepting on her behalf. It was very, very, very exciting to get to publish this story, and we talked about last year that it was like kind of like the year of Jillian. Yeah. And then this year was like the year of Jillian again. So I'm just going to say thanks on her behalf, and I will bring this to her somehow.
I feel like I am obligated to mention right now that I spent Friday in the archives of the Library of Congress and smooshed between pages by the likes of Will Eisner and George Herriman. I saw a Jillian Tamaki page, and I thought that was super fucking cool. I thought that was super cool. Okay, all right. We are now doing Outstanding Mini Comics, and your presenter for Outstanding Mini Comic is Whit Taylor. Whit Taylor, hold on. I gotta talk you up first. Everyone's gotta know how special you are. So like at the after party, it's like, who is she? I don't even care. Okay, Whit Taylor is an Ignatz nominated, Glyph Award winning, oh, you too, hey girl, cartoonist and writer from New Jersey. She has recently published work with Sparkplug Books, Ninth Art Press, and The Nib. Hi Matt, what's up? She also has written about comics for Panel Patter, the Comics Journal, Comics Workbook Magazine, and The Tiny Report. Without further ado, Whit Taylor.
Hi, how's it going? All right, Outstanding Mini Comic. Devil's Slice of Life by Patrick Crotty. Is that correct? Epoxy 5 by John Pham. King Cat number 75 by John Porcellino. Sex Fantasy number 4 by Sophia Foster-Dimino. And Women Are Reckoning by Aubrey. And the award goes to Sex Fantasy number 4, Sophia Foster-Dimino.
Thank you. This is huge for me. I really appreciate it. I've been coming to SPX since 2009, and I've always held the Ignatzes in such high regard, so this is a really big deal. I just want to thank the organizers and volunteers who make this such a good show, the jury for putting me on a ballot with such talented people that I really respect, the attendees for their enthusiasm, my parents for supporting me in pursuing a career in drawing, my friends and my peers who have given me so much feedback over the years that's really helped me, and my friend Ryan Sands, who's been encouraging me to do comics for almost a decade now. Thank you.
Next up, Best Anthology or Collection. Presenting the Best Anthology or Collection Ignatz Award for 2015 is Whitney Leopard. Whitney Leopard is an associate editor at Boom, all caps, exclamation point, Studios, where she worked on books like Adventure Time and Lumberjanes. Originally from Texas, she loves the West Coast, and she just adopted a kitty cat named Eleanor Rigby. So everyone, let's welcome Whitney Leopard.
All right, Outstanding Anthology or Collection. Drawn and Quarterly, 25 Years of Contemporary Cartooning, Comics, and Graphic Novels, edited by Tom Devlin, Christopher Olivieras, Peggy Burns, Tracy Herrin, and Julia Pohl Miranda. An Entity Observes All Things by Box Brown. How to Be Happy by Eleanor Davis. Pope Hats Number 4 by Ethan Rilley. Super Mutant Magic Academy by Jillian Tamaki. And the Outstanding Anthology or Collection winner is How to Be Happy by Eleanor Davis.
Hi, everybody. I wrote a speech, so oh my God, it's loading up on my phone. Please don't do this. Okay, it's really corny. I'm sorry I got emotional while I was writing it. I wanted to say thank you to this community, the mini comics and zines and alt comics community. I've been coming to SPX for over 10 years, seeing old faces year after year and new faces that show up and don't leave, and then they become old faces also. We're here because we want to show one another who we are. We come with stacks of shitty little stapled Xerox things that have our whole selves inside them. We give them out in defiance and in love. We say, this is me. So that's good. But what's even better is what happens in exchange. We turn and ask one another, who are you? We tell each other, it's okay to be honest. we reassuringly say, we're into it. So we're handed someone else's shitty little stapled Xerox thing, and they say, this is me. And we say, I see you inside here. And we say, thank you. And we say, I hope you make more. Thanks so much, everyone.
How am I supposed to come up here and be an asshole after listening to that? Oh, God. Okay. Now, our next presenter, by the way, I think someone should press back on their little button. I don't think that should be up yet, should it? Yes, it should. Never mind. You're right. Go for it. Sorry, I misread something. Okay. Hi. Whatever. Okay. We are now going to present the Ignatz, the 2015 Ignatz for the best series. Our presenter is Laura Terry. Laura, cool your jets. I gotta talk her up. Laura Terry lives, draws, and loves comics in Brooklyn, New York. Her graphic novel, Graveyard Shakes, will be published in 2017 by Scholastic. Yeah, buddy. This weekend, she premieres her latest comic, Adorable Empire, pictured on screen, featuring menacing woodland creatures. So please, everyone, give it up for Laura Terry.
Okay, I'm presenting for Outstanding Series, and I love SPX. Okay, Dumb by Georgia Weber. Frontier, edited by Ryan Sands. March by John Lewis, Andrew Aiden, and Nate Powell. Popats by Ethan Riley. And Sex Fantasy by Sophia Foster-Dimino. Oh my gosh. I didn't peek. Sex Fantasy by Sophia Foster-Dimino.
Thank you so much.
I saw that one coming. I'm very perceptive. Okay, our next award is for Best Online Comic. The intro, or the people who will be awarding Best Online Comic are the authors of Johnny Wander, Yuko Ota, and Ananth Hirsch. Yeah. They didn't write much about themselves here, but they urge you to go to johnnywander.com to read their joint efforts. Their latest book is Lucky Penny, coming from Oni Press in early 2016. And are they not the most adorable couple in comics, ladies and gentlemen? Aren't they cute? Give it up!
Hey, y'all. Okay, we're gonna read these.
Hey, friends. So, for Outstanding Online Comic, the nominees are The Bloody Footprint by Lily Carre,
Carriers by Lauren Weinstein,
Mom Body by Rebecca Rohr,
Oh Human Star by Blue Delaquanti,
and Witchy by Ariel Reese. Woo! And the winner is The Bloody Footprint by Lily Carré.
Thank you guys so much. Thanks also to Nathan Huang at the New York Times for inviting me to do the story in the first place and working on it with me. And Warren, Birthday Boy, thank you so much for having me out and your support, and all of SPX for your support. It's a really special event, and I'm really honored to be here. So thank you guys.
Okay. Oh, this guy. All right. So, hi, Chip. What's up? We are now doing Best New Talent for 2015, and our presenter is Chip Mosier. Am I pronouncing that right?
Yeah.
Awesome. Chip Mosier is a 20-year veteran of the comics industry. Oh, no. Wrong. Whatever.
40.
Yeah. Shut up. Veteran of the comics industry, having helped all caps, boom, exclamation point, comics come to fruition, and is now the VP of Communications and Marketing at none other than Comixology. So everyone, big round of applause for Chip Mosier.
I started working at a female-owned comic shop in 1987, so I think I'm unfortunately a 30-year veteran of the comic shop. I was young, so. I have a lot of free drink tickets to give out.
What's up?
Make it rain!
So, if you'll forgive me, just a little moment before we dive in, I just want to talk a little bit about Comixology. I have the privilege to work at a company where we sit around a table and we think, like, what are the goals of Comixology Submit? And, you know, we look at each other and, like, it would be great if people didn't have to go to another medium to make a living. I think, you know, Comixology is a really special place. There are a lot of passionate people that work there. How many people in this room work at Comixology or have worked? It's Lawrence Dirks, it's Eric Arroyo, Harris, Felony Comics, there's John Roberts, co-founder right over there. So Comixology Submit, we're sponsoring the Ignatz. If you haven't submitted your self-published work to submit, you should. We like to make people who make comics money. We believe that people who make comics should be able to make a living making comics, and that's one of our goals. So, thank you for listening to my little pitch before. Spike, you're on Comixology Submit.
Actually, I am on Comixology Submit, and I make a nice chunk of change. It's not a joke, you should totally go for it.
Jen Vaughn, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that, too.
It's paid rent one.
Okay, yeah. So everyone deserves a free drink ticket for listening to me babble on. I almost chucked up there, too. Okay, next slide. Oh, yeah, promising new talent. I'm such a jerk. M. Dean, KM, and RP, and 1971. Thank God that's written out. Sophia Foster-Dimino, Sphincter, Sex Fantasy. I've been waiting all night to say those back to back with a pause. I've been practicing. Because together, you know, it's still okay. Dakota McFadzian. Don't get eaten by anything. I was going to try to joke about all the titles, but I just won't, because it would be sad. Jane May, Soft. You're tripping me up. You're tripping me up, Vaughn. Gina Winbrandt, Big Pussy. Oh, yeah. I got to stop.
You took it home.
I know. Yeah. I took it home. And the winner is Sophia Foster-Dimino. Sphincter. Sex Fantasy. Promise of New Talent. It's awesome. I'm going to get out of your way.
You also took the whole script. Now you took the whole script.
Thank you again. I just wanted to shout out again my fellow nominees in all these categories. They're incredibly talented people, and I'm honored to be among them. And it just feels great that they're being recognized also. And I also want to thank again everyone who attends SPX. I feel that as an artist, I get so much valuable creative progression from having conversations with people here and finding new work and meeting people who give me direct feedback that makes it all worthwhile. Thank you so much.
And on Sophia's behalf, I thank everyone here who is now going to force her to explain to airport security why there are three bricks in her luggage. Okay. We are now checking out the best comic. It says best here. It says outstanding there. Let's go with outstanding. That's fancier. It's got more syllables. Okay. The outstanding comic of 2015. The presenter for the Ignatz for Outstanding Comic of 2015 is Ed Luce. Isn't he a precious baby angel? Ed is the creator of Wovable Oaf, that's Wovable with a W, whose title character can be seen on the chest of hunky dudes and sassy lasses in t-shirt form. Often referred to as the Scott Pilgrim of gay comics, Oaf. I think it works. Okay. Oaf has made appearances in Maximum Rock and Roll, Bear Magazine, Fur, The Love of Hair, and No Straight Lines, 4 decades of queer comics from Fantagraphics. So, without further ado, Ed Luce.
Just a really quick SPX fashion note. I'm glad to see that the battle jacket is coming back into vogue. I thought I was going to be overdressed until Alexis came up, so I'm glad to see. I'm not going to ask you who wore it best. It was Alexis. And Sam, you're next year. But the nominees for Outstanding Comic are Borb by Jason Whittle. The Nature of Nature by Disha Wallander. The Oven by Sophie Goldstein. Pope Hats Number 4 by Ethan Riley. And Weeping Flower Grows in Darkness by Chris McKay. And the winner is The Oven by Sophie Goldstein.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
So there's a lot of people to thank, but there's three people I want to thank who I hope this will mean the most to. The first is Chris Pitzer, who many of you have known for much longer than me, so I can only add to the praise that should be heaped on him. He's a great guy, and published this book, if you don't know, okay. And the second is one of my closest friends for many years, who I'm, public speaking, who I'm very happy to have here with me, and my sometimes comics collaborator, Jen Jordan. I love you. And the third person is my boyfriend, Carl Antonowitz, who is not sitting with me. I don't know where he is. But he puts up with a lot, and I'd like to think gets a lot back for his trouble. So, but thank you, guys. This is an honor. Thank you.
Pro tip, I love everything Sophie does. Okay, but anyway. Next up, we have Outstanding Graphic Novel for 2015, and our presenter for Outstanding Graphic Novel is Layla Abdelrazak. Layla is the author and illustrator of Badawi, a coming-of-age graphic memoir about her father's childhood growing up in a Palestinian refugee camp in Lebanon. Layla has also created short zines about traveling through Palestine, why you should boycott Israel, and her severe migraine problem. Sorry about that. Wow. Real bad? Yeah. That sucks. I'm sorry. Okay. Anyway, without further ado, Layla Abdelrazak, everyone.
Outstanding graphic novel nominees, Beauty, by Kara Scott and Hubert. The Oven by Sophie Goldstein. Woo! Rav by Mickey Z. St. Cole by Noah Van Sciver. And Wendy by Walter Scott. And the winner is The Oven by Sophie Goldstein.
Man, I'm going to pull like a Sophia Foster-Dimino here or something. Thanks, guys. This is great.
Strength, my friends, for we are nearly done. Okay, our final presenter. This is the last one. Yeah, there's one brick. Cool. I can count. What's up? All right, our final presenter for the evening is Gemma Coral. She'll be presenting Best Artist of 2015. Gemma is an illustrator, writer, artist, and a special guest from all the way across the Atlantic. Her recent books include The Pictured Warrior's Guide to Life from Andrews McMeel and A Pug's Guide to Etiquette, which, having known several pugs, I can assure you none of them have read. So, all right, thank you very much for coming, everyone, for our final presentation of the night, the fabulous Gemma Coral.
Hello. Okay, the nominees for Outstanding Artist are Emily Carroll for Through the Woods. Yeah. Ed Luce for Wubbable Oath. Yeah. Roman Muradov for In a Sense, Lost and Found. Yeah. Gillian Tamaki for Super Mutant Magic Academy. And Noah Van Sciver for St. Cole. And the award for Outstanding Artist goes to Emily Carroll.
I'm sure Emily would have thanked her publisher, her wife, and all of Canada.
Woo! Okay. Ladies, gentlemen, non-binary, agender folk, and all those I have neglected to list due to my ignorance. Thank you so much for coming. We appreciate your attendance of the Ignatz every year so all the nominees and the winners alike can know how much they are appreciated. I think the prom will be starting soon, and if you go to that, enjoy, or if you're an old woman like me and you're going upstairs to go to bed, enjoy. There's usually like a Law and Order like marathon on at this time, or if you're really lucky, you can catch like 2020 or something on TLC. It's always like someone getting murdered. And nothing. Anyway, that's what I'm gonna do. All right, thank you so much for coming, everyone. Also, go get a drink ticket from Chip. He's got a million.
What should we do with...